Hello everyone, we are live here in Brazil at Amani Institute, and we just finished the Managing Happiness course with Eiji and Shimizu.
Nobody wants to leave yet. So Eiji and Shimizu is, as we shared earlier on Facebook, is a producer of a movie, a documentary called Happy, and he's also a media producer and facilitating workshops all over the world on managing happiness, and we have invited him the second time now to teach this for our fellows as part of the postgraduate certificate in social innovation management, and we will find out in a second why we think that it makes sense to have this as part of our course for change makers.
Okay.
Hello. Hi, Eiji. Thank you so much. So I'm Geraldine. I'm working with the Money Institute, and this is Eiji. Say hi to the world.
Hello to the world.
All right, let's sit down. I just wanted to share with the rest of the world a little bit of what we've been doing here, and to see, you know, what do you think is reason why it makes sense for change makers to learn about managing happiness?
Social entrepreneurs are here to work to make other people happy, right? And it's very important to know what kind of happiness we are talking about. Certainly, this pleasurable happiness gives somebody something and, you know, lots of pleasurable, you know, thing, then that's also good. But happiness is not only that pleasurable feeling. There can be like a contentment, satisfaction, joy, and you know, if you're not careful, you think that, okay, give them food and shelter and they'll be happy in a social entrepreneurship. It's equally important to understand that, you know, building a community, you know, doesn't give pleasure, but gives contentment. Serving people and respecting their dignity also, you know, bring a different kind of happiness. So hopefully through this 3 to 4 days workshop, participants know what kind of happiness there are, and I want them to feel it. Then I want them to pass it them on to the people who need help, or the Amani students.
Yeah, thank you so much. Yeah, you know, it's interesting because a lot of the people who come to Amani Institute, so about a third of our fellows are people that want to change a career from the corporate sector to the social change sector. And you actually have a story like this too, right? Because when you shared with us that when you decided to produce the Happy movie, you actually changed your life completely. And you resigned and you went for it, and it changed your life, and I know you've changed many other lives. And so people come to us to learn how they can change their life. I think it's because they are looking for more alignment and this understanding that they would be more happy and more fulfilled if they apply what they know, what they can do, their strengths to something that is a greater good. So there's a lot more people out there. Maybe they're even watching right now, and there's a lot more people out there, of course, that are not part of this program. And I would like to ask you, what do you think are maybe one or three things that somebody can do today to start aligning like that, or start creating more happiness in their lives, more meaning in their lives?
More meaning. It's interesting that nowadays, like, you don't have to take a running course to learn what makes people happy, you know. Many people, you know, don't come to a money, but they go to yoga class, they go to meditation class, and all these, you know, things that you can learn. In a way, you know, people are trying to find like spirituality. Whether they use the term spirituality or not, many people are trying to learn that sort of stuff. Sadly, many people think that the spirituality is only attainable in the Himalayas or you know, this ashram in India, or like a monastery in Thailand. But his home is Karnataka, very important figure in Tibetan Buddhism, said that spirituality is not only residing in the Himalayas. Actually, spirituality is here with us, especially when you are dealing with a difficult person, your mother-in-law, or your kid doesn't stop crying, or when you are queuing up in a long, long line at the bank. That's where spirituality comes in. That's where you have to deal with your emotions. You have to be compassionate with other people. And I think just knowing that, you don't have to go all the way to Mount Everest, and you can achieve spirituality on a day-to-day basis.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Something that I wanted to share.
Yeah, great, thank you so much. And I found it interesting because a big thing that came out, I think, in this course also is that simple acts of compassion that is more than empathy, but like empathy plus action, so to serving others actually, you know, creates happiness in us. And a lot of people say, well, but then it's egotistical, you know, but it's like, for me it's interesting because why should that be opposite?
Right.
Why should we feel good opposite to doing something good? That's the way. For me, it makes sense to bring together
and
own that. Yeah.
I'm also engaged in a kind of like a social entrepreneurship, and my message to future social entrepreneur is exactly that. Many think that you know, you do volunteer work, you start the social entrepreneurship, and often these people encountered some kind of criticism from very cynical people. You know, they come up to you and say, hey, Gigi, you are doing this, Amani, helping other people because you feel miserable, you know, because you think that will make you happy. Kind of like cynical way of approach. But when students who are learning social entrepreneurship receive that kind of cynicism, I want them to have a nice smile back to this person and say, exactly, you know, that is the whole point. You know, you serve other people, you help other people because you feel good about yourself and there's nothing wrong with it at all. And that's the whole point of our existence. So, yeah, that's my answer.
Yeah, I love it. That's really cool.
Yeah.
And I think, you know, one of the things that is that we see as a problem in actually the broader social change sector, including international development, NGOs, humanitarian aid, a lot of people can become very cynical, as you're saying, right? And I remember somebody was saying, cynical people is just very disappointed idealists, right? And some of the things that we've been talking about in this course about mindfulness and how you can manage yourself and your energy better is actually something really important for people to know that are working that in a field that sometimes is very challenging. And if I work every day, let's say in humanitarian aid and catastrophes, I see very bad things happening. It's very important for me. How can I still be happy and justify that? And how can I, you know, remain healthy in the long run and not burn out immediately? And so I think it's incredibly valuable what you're sharing. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah. I wanted to see, is there anyone that has been asking questions or is there any questions?
Yeah.
Okay, great. So I think that's it. Thank you so much for sharing also some of the insights with the rest of the world. Eiji can be found. I shared his website and you can probably ask him to also run a course for you. And I know that there's very interesting media work coming out soon from you as well.